because I wrote this worship song when my wife came to me and said to me, Johnny, my mother is sick, and could you write a song for my mother? And so this song is a song about healing that can come to all people who trust God. We're going to unify healing on this side of life or on that side of eternity. Amen.
Amen.
Is what you do. Oceans pop and crash in. Waves for you. Changing things. Into the saints. Is something only you can do.
I have no idea what that was.
Caucasian or American.
I'm
what it is.
They're both very, what they call the states, whitewash.
So, yellow on the outside, white on the inside.
Yeah, speaking of that, so we're really important. I mean, like both of you. You guys have a decent American accent.
Well, does anybody know where I'm from? Where I'm from? I was raised in New Jersey, but I was born in California.
Counting house.
Yes. Born in California.
Yeah, I was born and raised in Jersey, through and through. Yeah.
Wait, so does that mean that you guys hold a dual citizenship, or...?
No, both U.S. citizens.
Both U.S. citizens, huh? So, how did you get into the music, like, as a career?
Well, I mean, just like everybody here, I guess the young people who love music. Everyone loves music. Yeah. So growing up, I've always had a passion for singing and just performing, and I always joined, you know, in junior high, I would go all like the talent shows, and you know, in high school I did Mr. Spartan, my school mascot was Spartan, so Mr. Spartan was when all the high school senior guys got to sing, and it was like a Mr. Universe, you go out in a tuxedo and stuff, and I was the first Asian ever, minority, to ever win Mr. Spartan in our high school. So. And after that, I came to Korea and just been doing music ever since. Yeah.
So how did you meet the PJ? What does PJ stand for?
PJ stands for Pastor Johnny.
Pastor
Johnny. You can teach English. This is Pastor Johnny. I mean, his first name is Johnny, but instead of calling him Pastor Johnny all the time, since we've known each other for so long, anybody who's close to PJ just calls him PJ.
Yeah, so how did you get to meet PJ? I mean, what's the relationship?
PJ and I used to go to the same church, the same ministry in the past, and he came up to me one day after service, and he asked me, he was like, would you be interested in being a part of a Christian project to, you know, sing for God? And
actually, to back up, we first started Bible study.
Yeah,
I have no idea that Gabe and I mean, I'm not a musician, and I'm not in the music industry. I wasn't at that time, and we were just doing Bible study. That's how
we met. Yeah,
Brian, you were just a pastor who did Bible study.
You just mentioned you weren't at that time, so are you saying you are in the music industry now?
Kind of. Back then, he just did Bible study for a lot of celebrity hip-hop kids, like me, T1 from Super Junior, a couple times Amber from FX.
Announcers, and there was like musicians, very famous musicians.
What's funny is, when we were mentioning the stars, all the Americans are like, what are those people? All the Koreans are like,
didn't we have just a Timberlake too? Sorry, just joking.
An honest question for Ryan and third day, right? I heard that you guys are going to prepare for Nick.
Yes.
Are you guys excited about it? I mean, I know you are. You were there lots of times.
Very excited because I've never met him personally, but I've seen him through, you know, YouTube clips and watched a lot of his videos. And just to see him is just inspiring, you know, for him, what he's gone through in his life. And he's always such a happy person. And I think we all could learn from that. You know, because we all complain about how life is difficult, we go through rough times. Everybody has difficult times, you know. So I just wish that, you know, if you are going through difficult times, to overcome them, because life is short, and you know, Jesus would never throw anything towards us an obstacle that we couldn't face. And I feel like Nick is a great example of that.
That is true.
So to all the kids out there, I would say get a tattoo. Oh. After you're 30, okay? Where did that come from? Because Brian has a pretty cool tattoo on his leg.
But you gotta get it after when you're 30, because that's when Brian got here.
It's Philippians 4:13.
Yeah,
I can do all this 30 with my strength. So.
And you know that verse, Philippians 4:13, that's totally Nick. And you know, he has, if you don't know about him, he has no legs, no arms, but he lives his life to the fullest. And he lives his life like there's no tomorrow. And he does it because he really believes that God speaks over his life. And so I think it's really neat if you go out and see him and check out the end.
I just realized something. Thank you for throwing my age out there. Over 30.
Over 30? Can you guys believe he's over 30?
Yes!
Thank you! Security! She's a friend of ours.
Also, why don't we continue with the two, we have two more songs for us.
Yeah.
So we can continue with that.
So the next song that we're going to sing is a newer song. It's on the newest album for Dirt Wave. And there's two versions, an English version and a Korean version. In the English version, we have Pastor Johnny and Siwon from Super Junior singing it. And in the Korean version, it's me and Siwon singing it. So if you guys get the album, it's a great album. Go get it, pay for it. Don't download it for free. And the song is called I Stand.